how did you like start to be interested in investing in properties?
I started as a commercial banker at Standard Chartered Bank. At the time, my job is to actually help clients to save money, do business loan, do trade line facilities and overdraft. My job is very simple, is to help them to simply make more money through what they have. Based on commercial bankers' portfolio, we can only deal with bosses and not individuals. So we are forced to mix with forces, talk to them. Initially, it's like, if we can just like bosses, they are smarter, more intimidating. It's not easy to get close to such people. So after meeting them for a couple of years, I personally feel that they are still human beings. There are some tall ones, there are some very good ones. Tall ones are the ones who are not doing the very well ones. The very good ones are the freaking rich kind of people who have maybe 30 to 50 properties in Singapore. I started learning from them, and because me as a banker, I can ask any questions I want. They will just answer to my questions. I will ask things like, how do you make this kind of money? Source of income? Why do you have so many properties? They will just tell me, oh, you just based on this and that, you just buy lah. So that's how I get myself interested in buying properties. I think there's one time I was waiting for a client. He was like late for 45 minutes. I waited for this client and he sat down and I was like, never mind, just wait for you. He told me the reason of why he's being late. So he gave me a name card. Oh, I just met with my Merrill Lynch banker. I was like, thanks for telling me why you are late. And he was telling me, oh, he's looking for properties to buy. His budget was like 10, 20 million kind of property portfolio. So I was at Hawaii Tower and we all know that Hawaii Tower is a very old project. So it's like, you stay here, you may not have a lot of money. So of course he asked me whether I can do residential properties because he has a few. He also do have commercial properties as well. And because my job, I can only do commercial property. When he asked me whether I can do residential, as a banker, I always say yes. So he told me, oh, actually I have 48 residential properties and I have like 7-8 commercial properties. 48 properties in Singapore. But because my job is for commercial property, so I say, okay, can you please tell me what are the 7 commercial properties that you have? I have property at Suntec. So I asked him, what's the valuation of your property at Suntec? He said about 25 to 30 million. I was thinking, I know Suntec is expensive, but it's not that expensive. So I told him, well, actually there is about 5-6 million type only. Oh, sorry, I have the whole floor. What? So I was like, oh, okay. Of course, at the back of my head, it's like, this person may be bullshitting me. As a banker, we've seen too many kinds of people. You say good, usually people who say good, they don't really do that well. So I went back to office, so I sat down on my computer. I actually keyed his IC number. The computer, it says, access denied, please contact customers PB, which is private banker. So I told my boss, hey, computer spoiled. Because I think that's my first time having this kind of scenario where I key people's IC and say access denied. So my boss, wow, this person is like those special character one. If they want to issue check, they just call, I want you to issue check or 500k, please issue check. Maybe he have some pin code or whatever. Okay, get it done. So from there, then I know that, wow, there are people having crazy number of properties. That's where I started. I want to be like them.